Welcome to my channel MK Mediguide Lectures, Learning with Artworks like Drawing and Calligraphy. In this video, we will discuss about the dexamethasone mechanism of action, which is recently approved to be used in severe SARS-CoV-2 infection, and lastly, the side effects of dexamethasone. SARS-CoV-2 is a novel coronavirus reported in China is responsible for the pandemic of COVID-19. Dexamethasone, recently approved to be used in severe COVID-19 patients diagnosed with cytokine storm. Dexamethasone is a member of corticosteroids, also known as glucocorticosteroids. Glucocorticoids are just steroids, which are among the most widely used drugs in the world and are effective in many inflammatory and immune diseases. Dexamethasone is a very potent, long-acting, and highly selective to glucocorticoid receptors as compared to mineralocorticoid receptors. Being a steroid, it has a lot of diverse actions, but here we will just focus on mechanism of action leading to cytokine storm diminishing property of dexamethasone for what it is approved to be used in SARS-CoV-2 infected patients. Cytokine storm is responsible for many deaths in older patients. Patients above 60 are more susceptible to cytokine storm because immune systems of aged patients are not strong enough as the young ones and fail to keep balance between the pro-inflammatory cytokines and anti-inflammatory cytokines, as large number of pro-inflammatory cytokines are produced in aged patients, which result in cytokine storm. Furthermore, dexamethasone is not recommended to be used in asymptomatic or mild patients, as it acts as immune suppressive agent and may exacerbate the condition of patients. Mean selecting of dexamethasone for treating COVID-19 patients is done based on risk-benefit ratio. Dexamethasone is only palliative and do not remove the cause of inflammation. The underlying disease continues to progress while clear manifestations are reduced. Dexamethasone in COVID-19 regulates the immune response at both the cellular and transcriptional level. At the cellular level, glucocorticoids can induce apoptosis of T lymphocytes, neutrophils, basophils, and eosinophils to reduce inflammation. While to show effect at transcriptional level, dexamethasone is a lipophilic drug and diffuses readily across the membrane of the target cell and exert its anti-inflammatory effect by binding to intracellular receptors named glucocorticoid receptors, mainly in immune cells, especially T cells, to reduce SARS-CoV-2 infection. Glucocorticoid receptors, or GRs, exist largely in the cytoplasm in a complex with chaperone proteins. Once dexamethasone have bound to GRs, changes in the receptor structure result in dissociation of these proteins, thereby exposing nuclear localization signals on glucocorticoid receptors. This results in rapid transport of the activated GR dexamethasone complex into the nucleus, where two GR molecules bind together as a homodimer and bind to DNA at specific sequence in the promoter region of corticosteroid responsive genes known as glucocorticoid response element. Interaction of GR with glucocorticoid response element classically leads to an increase in gene transcription through the production of mRNA, which may encode anti-inflammatory proteins affecting inflammation at different stages, for example, annexin 1 or lymphocytin 1, which promotes neutrophil detachment in apoptosis. Interleukin 10 with anti-inflammatory activity and inhibitor of nuclear factor kappa B. Less commonly, GR homodimers interact with negative glucocorticoid response element to suppress genes, particularly those linked with side effects of corticosteroids. In controlling inflammatory process, the major effect of dexamethasone is to inhibit the synthesis of multiple inflammatory proteins through transcription factors that encode these proteins. These transcription factors are nuclear factor kappa B and activator protein 1. These are important transcription factors of gene expression and contribute to the control of many cytokine genes. When the cell detects inflammatory stimuli such as interleukin 1 beta or tumor necrosis factor alpha, these transcriptional factors are activated as they are pro-inflammatory transcription factors. They bind to specific regions in DNA and start transcription of the genes into mRNA and then to many inflammatory proteins such as cytokines, inflammatory enzymes, adhesion molecules, and inflammatory receptors. In these, cytokines, and specifically pro-inflammatory cytokines, are the key players here in COVID-19. Pro-inflammatory cytokines include interferon alpha, interferon gamma, interleukin 1 beta, interleukin 6, interleukin 12, interleukin 17, interleukin 18, tumor necrosis factor alpha, granulocyte colony stimulating factor, granulocyte macrophage colony stimulating factor, and C-reactive protein. Among them, interleukin 6 is more important as it is the key protein in the coronavirus-induced cytokine storm. These cytokines will act on other cells to release more and more pro-inflammatory cytokines, which eventually results in cytokine storm due to the overproduction of pro-inflammatory cytokines contrast to anti-inflammatory cytokines. These pro-inflammatory transcription factors are also activated in all inflammatory diseases and play a critical role in amplifying and spreading the inflammatory process. But in normal individuals, this stage is followed by the production of anti-inflammatory cytokines which subside the inflammation process. Dexamethasone-activated glucocorticoid receptors interact functionally with the actions of nuclear factor kappa B and activator protein 1 without the necessity of binding to DNA, and this is called non-genomic effect of corticosteroids. These transcriptional factors are inhibited by activated glucocorticoid receptors by various mechanisms and block their transcriptional activities to make mRNAs and subsequently pro-inflammatory cytokines. In addition to this pathway, dexamethasone influences the mRNA stability of inflammatory genes by regulating the expression of tetraprolin, for short TTP. TTP plays an important role by destabilizing the mRNA of many pro-inflammatory cytokines and targeting them for degradation. It allows dexamethasone to switch off the ongoing production of inflammatory proteins after the inflammatory gene has been activated. With these different actions of dexamethasone, the cytokine storm induced by SARS-CoV-2 can be controlled and saved the life of many severe patients. Unfortunately, various adverse effects are associated with corticosteroid treatment. These effects include glaucoma, increased risk of infection, full wound healing, osteopenia, increased appetite, emotional retardation, hyperglycemia, and hypertension. Peptic ulcer may perforate asymptomatically with long-term treatment, and indiscriminate use of corticoids is hazardous. Thanks for watching our video and support us by subscribing our channel, and do like and comment below.